Okay. Just to give you a bit of background, the living room, the original intent of the living room was when we looked at the homeless population in Nanaimo and what was available to them. We understood that they could possibly get a place to sleep at night by accessing an emergency shelter, but there was nothing for them during the day. And it left them in a position where they had to sort of wander the streets of our city all day long. And it's because it's kind of cold here, that's not a good proposition in the winter. That service will be virtually the same. It'll be running out of the Salvation Army instead of out of the building on Maple Street. So it's going to continue, and the intent is still the same, to give the folks a place to go during the day and connect them with services. So the upgrade is that there'll be probably more services available to them within the Salvation Army setting, because there's transitional housing. There'll be a welfare officer located in that building, et cetera, et cetera. So hopefully that'll work even better than it has so far, and we're able to fine-tune it a little bit.
I was told I was banned from there.
For how long?
For 6 months, the whole winter period.
Right.
Right? And because I was banned from there, they wouldn't let me in the Salvation Army. Right? So.
And it's not a way of life. It's a way of dying. It is. The only way you're going to end up is dead, and you're going to be a statistic. It's the truth. It's the God's honest truth. I don't want to die. I want to live.
Sounds like there was a moment, maybe not too long ago, that you've sort of have begun to take responsibility in that sense for your own life. So when did you realize that became a choice for you, of not having a home? Because until that time, you obviously didn't realize you were making that choice. So what, if you don't mind me asking, what happened? What kind of opened your eyes to make you realize that you can't deny?
Yes. You know,
addiction and homelessness in your life.
I don't know where the point was, but there's a moment of clarity. All of a sudden, I seen what was going on. Right, you know, the way I've been living, being drug addicted and everything. I kept telling myself that it's normal. That this was normal. Right. You know, and it's far from normal. It's pretty screwed up. And that's not the way I was brought up. I wasn't brought up to believe that. And it's incredible how a person can lie to himself and tell himself that everything's okay. And it doesn't help matters that you've got a whole bunch of people around you that are judging you constantly. Nobody's there to help. That all they want to do is judge, because if they can point a finger at somebody, then their life's okay, right? And that's what's going on. You got everybody that's got hell in their life. They're looking at somebody else to say, well, I'm not that bad.
I'm walking down that lonesome lane, hung down my head and cried. I wept and I cried on the willow tree, and I feel a deep blue sea. Mama, dead, Papa can't be found, and my brother on the county road. Says I done been to that long plank walk, and I'm on my way back home. Beauty calls me to weep, beauty calls me to moan, beauty calls me to be my home. I cried last night and the night before, and I swore not to cry no more. Beauty called me to weep, beauty called me to moan, beauty called me to leave my home. I got no money and he called me no honey. I have to weep and moan. In 1899 he got killed on that streetcar line. It took him down that smoke. It rose, brought him back on that two-lane bone.